yes, I know I look like poop, but I feel like poop. You know, it's very hot and humid. I just crossed over from Texas to Louisiana, heading into Leesville. I'm telling you, I've been dripping. When you don't have an air conditioner, and I put the fans down for the dogs so that they can get more circulation, so. Oh my goodness, it's hot and humid. But I've accomplished a couple of things even as I'm traveling. I made a few phone calls and I can't tell you right now. I'll let you know probably in a day or two, but one of the things that I was trying to accomplish is coming through. So hopefully this is going to start changing some things. I hope so.
My daughter needs help badly. Badly. And the only way she's going to get it if she recognizes that she needs it badly.
That man that has been abusing her, well, I made a phone call as I'm traveling, and I talked to the dispatcher of the police department, and I asked her, could I complain, which I knew the answer was no, about the physical abuse on my daughter by a certain individual, and of course she said no. I said, let me explain to you. The day they were bringing the baby home from the hospital, he tried to run off the road and kill both her and the baby. When she was pregnant, he choked her, lifting her off the floor by her throat. After she had the baby, he choked her so bad she had bruises around her neck. Then he broke her pelvis. And the last few days, he's been beating the heck out of her. I said, you've got to do something because my daughter's going to die. If you don't do something, my daughter will die. She's not going to turn him in. So you all have got to do something. And so anyway, they went to the house, they saw my daughter, she's all bruised up. The cops talked to her, and as we speak, there is a warrant issued out for his arrest. So you see, you can accomplish things from a distance. You sure can. And I did, and I'm thankful for it. I am so thankful that that's going to happen. Now, what's going to happen with her, I don't know. What's going to happen with my baby, I have no idea. I'll know more next week. But I hope whatever it is that I'll be able to hold that beautiful baby in my arms again and let her know how much I love her. And maybe this was the bottom of the barrel for my daughter. Maybe she hit bottom when she loses six kids because of drugs and because of a man that isn't worth nothing. So anyway, that's the deal. That's what's going on. But I'll let you know more of the results of all this in the next few days. I think court is on Tuesday, so let's see what we can do. Anyway, thank you all. I love each and every one of you, and I want to give you a big hug, but I can only give you one now. There's a big truck. So don't forget, guys, to like, share, comment, and subscribe. And remember, I love each and every one of you.